Welcome to today's meditation session. It's damn. If you look on the screen, we've just had an X flare going off. X239, I believe. Now that went off around 1:30 or 13:30 UTC, and yeah, you know, it did affect me a bit. Some of those spiky sensations that we feel. So, I did feel that, you know. But right now, it's going all the way down. It's a C. Gone back up to an M. Oh, it's on the ascendance. All right. No. Hold on. Yes. Oh shit. It's going back up. Ooh. Okay. So I expect to feel that energy then. All right. I get you. Alright, yeah, no problems. So, whatever blockage I'm gonna speak about, we'll wait to see if it levels off, tapers off, or goes back down. Because after just unleashing that X there, I doubt if it's, you know, we've had double X's before, so, yeah, it could be, man. So the physiological pains you'll be feeling, there's an explanation. And those of you who are triggered into destructive conversations in your head, or contemplations even, you just know that it's a natural cause, and it's just the way you're built. Yeah, it's the way this form is, the human form. It's just the way we're built. We're triggered like that. It's kind of similar to a bit flip. Even some of your computers will glitch. That's called a bit flip. Most of the time anyway, it's a bit flip. One of the bits in the billions that it has, or trillions, has flipped, where it shows a zero, but now it's showing a one. One. So things like that. But yeah, let's get ready for the meditation now. I'm trying to sit up a bit different cushions. right, let's get on with it. Okay. People still playing fireworks season. It's more of a season nowadays. Or it's something to celebrate. Yeah. Oh, here we go. Obviously, I feel a blockage. But at least I know what it is. I don't have to complain too much. Yeah. So it's I'm anticipating that graph will go up. Yeah, it should go up a bit more once we got to the 17:30. It's on the 17:15 now. I think it would have gone up. Yeah. But otherwise, that's the main disturbance I should be picking up right now, and I am picking up one. Yeah. So let's see. I don't know. Because that X was very huge. I'm probably still picking up that. Everyone should be charged up then, you know, at this time. So whatever I'm feeling, most probably those of you who watch this video, you might remember feeling that at this time. Oh yeah, and the colds and flus and things like that, yeah. This my power, because like when you put meat in a freezer, it lasts longer, yeah? That's because the decaying rate slows down. If decay is how we sense time, then I suppose you can say when it's in a colder environment, time slows down. It would look like time slowed down when you get a piece of meat they've taken out of the freezer that's been in there for a week, and you compare it to one that's been in the fridge for a few weeks. You know, it would have decayed less, like time slowed down. So in winter, my power is having to work with thicker or denser material, yeah, that's been slowed down, if you like, yeah. So the meditation feels different. Very, very different. It's good to have a natural reason. I mean there's nothing worse than a conspiratory reason. I feel insulted because everybody knows by now, if you've tried my mind, you know I've got a power in there. So if somebody tried to mess around with it in there, I would feel insulted. But if it's nature, that's all right. I told you, like, you know, you make allowances for that. You be like water when it comes to nature, you know. See what happens if it comes up on the 30 and 31. No, it's not there yet. Or have they sanitized it? I don't know. Nah, it should come up any second now, won't it? It's every 15 minutes. It's been around 15 minutes. There or thereabouts. If it doesn't, then they've sanitized it. They missed that one. The one that happened at 13:30 hours. face different. The elevated X flare, yeah, the flare today, the flares, they do have a healing component, you know. At the end of the day, it zaps everyone on the planet, so even your enemies get zapped up too by the flare, innit? As you meditate, you don't have to worry about the background noise, you know, because whatever people are doing to you in the background, if it's a power that attacks everything that tries to attack you, you just do your power, and whatever's trying to attack you don't need to know like that intricately. You do, like if you're doing prayer, as long as you do the prayers, you don't really need to worry about the constituents of what was attacking you to that level. You know, you just know it as a blockage. That's as far as I go into defining what's attacking me. It's a blockage. I don't go into identities and things like that. Of course, you can, if you're empathic, you can deduce characteristics and qualia from the blockage. It depends on what's relevant to you. What do you want to deduce? Some people's brains simple, so they'll deduce things which are just silly. But for me, I try to deduce whether that's sentient, yeah, in the human way of being sentient, or whether it's from this plane of existence. And how far from this plane is he existing from? All kinds of things. That's what I ask about whatever blockage is in me. You know? Some ask silly things like, oh yeah, okay. Does it love or hate? Stupidness. In each to their own. Each to their own, anyway. That's what I say. Each to their own. I'm trying to size up things. The way I look at it is simple, isn't it? Zap him, bug him, tag him, embalm him, burn him, scatter his ashes, dash him. That's how I say. Crazy. Boy, you're not equipped for judging, so why do you think it's you that does it? You would have needed this, the type free conscious ray gun, and it is me that has it. Anyway, this is the judgment hour, you know, and whatever develops from it, it was that, you know. So, it's gone down, it's gone down. Oh, good. Good, good, good. Right. Right. Still an M. It's kind of leveling out on M, yeah. Yeah. You'd rather it levels out somewhere at C, but on M. Mm-hmm. All right. This is not getting any worse, isn't it? For now. Yeah. All is not as it seems. One of them ones. It was in a movie somewhere. Research it. Can't remember it. Doing these videos also helps me learn how to communicate. Also teaches me not everything that's going on in your head you must say out loud. Sometimes the quiet part you need to contemplate on it first before you say it out loud. But I don't know, maybe change is in the air and we can speak a bit more freely than we did before in the past. In the recent past anyway. I don't know, but it's good exercise to learn not to just say whatever you're thinking in your mind, you know. Leave some to the imagination, you know. The need to tell others what you think. I don't know, we all suffer from that. Just working on another aspect with respect to what I need to fix about me. So yeah, even learning to talk proper, you know. learning to control how you are perceived. It's very important in this world, you know. I run my own narration in every life event that I have, you know. I'll be telling myself all kinds of things. When will I be famous? As soon as I realize that the audience is the voices in my head. You run your own narrative. If people are, if there is entities watching your mind, you got to not that you got to explain yourself, but you got to control how they perceive you. You know what I mean? It's not a matter of feeling like I need to explain myself. It's a matter of me controlling how I am perceived by their voices in my head, if they are real entities. Well, if they're entities that are watching, unidentified, anomalous even entities that are watching, objects even, yeah. To control how I'm perceived in whatever dimension they're from. I mean, damn, gotta make myself look good, innit? You know, somebody comes, oh, I'm an interdimensional being, I was watching you from another dimension. I'll know that, you know, at least you know, the way he perceives me would have been something I contributed to, you know, had input towards. It's always good to know. It's always good to have. So, yeah. As soon as you realize that, that's actually an audience that you have to treat, if you like. Yeah? Yeah, you get it. You get it from there. is, it's an obvious one today, you don't give it a name, you just try and detect, sense important things. If I believe it's a human presence, I start to try and guess how old it is, what sex it is, useful things, you know. You could even get how heavy it is. Oh shit, those the other eight. Oh right, yeah, good. Yeah, that was a bit of a struggle, so I went kind of radio silence here. trying to contain certain thought process that I didn't want to say. Kind of forgot whether I was speaking on or just thinking for a second. I'll play it back and It was an intense energy as well that I had to fight off. It's weird. What does your inner voice sound like? Does it sound the same as your outer voice? Is it possible to change what your inner voice sounds like? Can an imitated voice ever become your voice, your internal voice? If you took like laughing gas and your voice stuck like that, would your internal voice also sound like the voice you get when you take that laughing gas that makes your voice squeak? No. So what does your voice sound like? Oh dear. People lie, innit? Do you sound like a chipmunk? Nah. You know you're lying, because your inner voice don't sound like a chipmunk. Even if you change your voice to sound like a chipmunk, your inner voice still sound like you, innit? I sound like a chipmunk inside because I'm a chipmunk now. Be here if I wasn't onto something? Of course not. I once told a counselor what my predicament was, the kind of fuckeries that are going on, and the counselor themselves got scared. Because I have a tight free conscious ray gun, yeah, it helps me. I would have got so paranoid I wouldn't be able to cope with the outside. But going into it with that as my rod and stuff, that came from the Most High as well. I told you how I came about my power, and it was a dream. You know. So it was actually I'm not gonna say anything anyway. Yeah. So it's the rod that the Almighty gave me. It's supposed to be used for something else, but now I'm using it to heal my health. Didn't do any of that. What I was doing with it in the dream. So it looks like it's stabilized. during those moments where I'm ripping apart a demon, my speech will change. People can't, in this world, can't really see. What's that film? They Live or something? People just can't see, you know? But yet, when I start zapping, you hear somebody convulsing and making jerking noises like they're getting hurt. But to me, on the other end, I just sense a blockage. Yeah? But once I start seeing somebody visibly doing stuff, that's when I know that, oh, it was that, that's the blockage. From the other end, I'm thinking it's a flare, it's a possession. Well, it's a definitely possession then, isn't it? If somebody was behind it. So people can't see. When I'm tearing apart, okay, well, let's just say when I'm neutralizing a blockage, yeah? Yeah. My speech might change. I'm an empath. If I empathetically deduce that it's a human, I'm not saying I'm right. So I really shouldn't say nothing, because I'm probably right like 20-30% of the time. Yeah. But sometimes it has been people, though. I've seen people convulsing when I'm trying to clear my mind of people's of things that are locking it. Yeah, I've seen people standing there convulsing when I'm clearing stuff, yeah. So people making weird ass noises like somebody's zapping them. I have seen that. So you might hear my speech changing. My speech might become a bit dark in nature, a bit more spiritual, religiously themed, but it's not because I'm going crazy. It's because, like, I've empathetically, might be right, might be wrong. I have to eliminate all possible causes, however improbable. If I've eliminated the possible causes, then whatever's left must be true. Whatever's left must be the paranormal. That's the one you live last. Yeah, after you've exhausted all the other things it could be. Yeah, if that's the only one that's remaining, then that's the speech that I start doing. That's when I start talking funny, you know. Exorcism time. Yeah. Sometimes I might think it's an X-ray when it's a human being. You never know. Telling me to leave this part is like telling me to leave my health alone. Don't really give a fuck about, when it comes to my health, I don't give a fuck about anything else. Somebody says, I don't give a fuck, like you're doing it for your health alone. Like, I don't give a fuck if you give a fuck. If I give a fuck. When it comes to my health, I don't give a fuck about nothing. Whatever the point is, when it comes to my health, there's nothing that matters more than that. It's about there-ness. Why we put the Almighty Creator above everything else? Yeah, what's the point? What's the first point that you should always aim to get? The first point would be being there. All the other points are obsolete if you're not there to get them. If you want ice cream, you need to be there to get the ice cream. If you want to run a marathon, you need to be there to run a marathon. Whatever you're going to want in this world, if you're not there, it doesn't. You can't get what you want if you're not there. So the first and most important point to existence is to be there in existence. To be in existence for eternity means that all the other points to existence are there. But if you're not there, there's no point. So that's why we put the Almighty Creator, the one who makes there or here. That's why we put him above everything. Because if there is no there, there's no point to be gotten anywhere. So that's the first point, to be there. To exist, to be created, to be in creation, the creator. Yeah, you don't equate anything to the creator. Ah, people are cretins, man. Cretinous creatures. If you're to have one, if you're to choose one, let it be the creator. Whatever else you want to have in life, yeah, if you're to choose a point, make sure, yeah, that before you choose any other point, you choose the most fundamental point, which is to exist. Everything else you want to do in life will come after. Making sure you exist for eternity is more important than anything else you can come up with. Can't believe how stupid people are. So, in terms of what's the point of existing forever? The point of existing forever is so that you can get other points, because that's the most fundamental point. Without it, there's no other point. Otherwise, you're asking the next question, if you're being cynical, is why? What's the point of not existing forever, which is a point? So anyway, the first point you must get is to exist, and all the other things you think it's about will come after that. So what is life about? What are we here to do? To exist forever, that's one point. To get that point, none of us have ever got it. If you could figure out how to live forever, then you can move on to all the other points that you need to get. Until you figure that out, that's your if you're prudent, that should be the only point you're looking to get. We haven't got it yet. And if you haven't got it yet, return back to point one. Try and get it. Even if it takes eternity to get it. If it takes eternity, by the time we reach time equals infinity, we would have got it then. It's a point you never get until you've got it. And you won't get it until the end. So it must always be about living forever as the most fundamental point. I'm doing this for my health, not to show off. Don't you think I'll be high-end production if I was trying to show off? Very low end production, no editing even, no script. I don't even know what I'm gonna say in a couple of minutes time. Promised eternal life. What's the point to life? To get eternal life. All the other things I'll get after that. If you give a man a fish, you can fill in the blanks. Those of you who are slow, if you give a man a fish, he can feed himself for a day. You give him a fish net to do fishing with, you can feed a whole village forever. The first thing you want shouldn't be the fish, should be the fish net. It's a bit like that, eternal life. You call on Christ, innit? Who show you how? Mm-hmm. actually, I don't really have a point, but if I was to have one, it would be to live forever, innit? Then I could get fish. In fact, get everybody. Jesus did that. Everybody will be able to have fish.
Yeah.
Funny. The Indian once put 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish in a bag and fed 5. Everybody got fish. Yeah, he must know a trick. If there's a cheat code, I'm sure Jesus would know it. That's a man that looks like he might have figured out a trick on how to do eternal life. You need people like that. Man who knows of a trick. Oh man, well, everything's a trick, even consciousness a trick. So don't lose it. Don't see the back end of it. You lose it. It's like a superposition trick. What consciousness is. Try not to collapse that wave function that is your consciousness, please. Well, I don't care if you do, but I just if you do, I hope you pass out before you tell us what the secret to doing it is. So that's safe then, isn't it? Once you realize what consciousness is, you realize what your consciousness is, and you pass out right there. And then, oh shit, you might have written it down before then. Damn it. Destroy that shit there if you ever come back to consciousness. Oh boy. I hear there's forbidden books out there. I hope they don't have shit like that in it. When man loses consciousness from reading shit. Have you ever seen a painting that's so disgusting that you fall sick? It might be a painting that's so fucked up that you lose consciousness from looking at it. Those should be in forbidden books and them thing there. Nah. Can't be having them ones. It's going down, right? Good. Accuse you of bullying someone in your own mind. Bullying involves being in someone's intimate space, but when they're in yours, they actually not for this shit now. Yeah. You can't stand on my toes and then tell me I'm bullying you. Get off my toes first, you bully. Get off my mind is what I'll be telling those. There's no way I can bully anyone in my mind. I want them off me. And the fucking bully won't get off me. Imagine someone steps on your toes and you tell them no. Well, can you be accused of bullying? Somebody steps into your mind and you tell them no. How are they going to accuse you? You get out of my mind first before you accuse me of anything. Yeah. That's what bullying is, when somebody's told you to get off them. And you just stay on there. That's assault. Bullying involves assault. You're on my mind. I asked you to get off. You're still on there. It's like you're forcing yourself on me now. That's assault now, isn't it? There's no way somebody who's violating me like that can accuse me of bullying, man. What the hell? Yeah, went down. C7. Oh, good. Yeah. It went up a bit. From when I started, no, it was going downwards. Oh, yeah, downwards. Good. Phew. down is good, doesn't mean, it means that, yeah, it's a natural order of things. Look, it was on its way down anyway, and it just kept going that way. Yeah, finished the experiment a little early. Yeah, nothing in there, just being consistent with some numbers. It's not that consistent. Mistakes make it perfect, innit? So, yeah, man, that's the day to day, man. All right, enjoy.